You know, subhanAllah, look, the Muslims, mashallah, all of us, we love the deen. Na'am, we love the deen, no doubt about that. But I have noticed and I've observed there's a dirty war against Khalij, especially Saudi. Why? Because Saudi is a country is known to be Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Tawheed. But are they perfect? They're not perfect, brother. Muhammad ibn Salman, the last time I know, he was a human being. Has he changed to become a malaika or something? Is he still a human being, is he? Muhammad ibn Salman.
Why isn't he doing the same stuff Iran is doing?
Huh?
Outside, are they doing the same stuff
Iran? What are they doing? How? They're killing Sunnis where?
Yemen.
No, Yemen Houthis. Rafida.
Look. Hold on.
Yeah.
Are we choosing which sect are we going
to
kill?
No, I didn't say to you we're going to kill. What? No, no. Houthis, they were killing Sunnis in Yemen. Did you know that?
Ma'alish.
Okay. No, said ma'alish.
No.
No problem, akhi. It's no problem. My point is, did you know?
Mean that we're going to reply in the same way?
No, no. When the Houthis were killing Sunnis, do you know that?
When?
He didn't say subhanAllah. He's not aware. But no problem. I'm not just to rebuke you for not knowing that. But I'm just showing you what I was...
Something though, my brother. Yeah?
Go on.
You know, when I speak to the Qutbi side of people.
Yeah, Qutbi.
Them side of people.
Yeah.
Wallahi, they do have a dirty mouth.
Yeah.
They curse a lot.
Yeah.
Mothers, fathers, yeah. Sisters, daughters,
yeah.
Dogs, fish tank, anything. They're just cursing.
Wallahi, yeah.
I've seen that before.
Yeah.
But alhamdulillah, you Salafi brothers, I've never heard you even swear. Like, even
anything. Alhamdulillah, you know. I'm Algerian. Don't get it twisted. I get angry sometimes. I mean, North African, generally speaking, we get angry. You know, Moroccans, Algerians, we have some...
That's why I make you angry.
This guy, barakallah, you know. Wallahi, I have my shortcomings as well. You know, may Allah forgive us all. So in 2009, there is a place called Sa'da in Yemen. Sa'da was known for to be Ahl Sunnah al Jama'ah. There was a man called Imam Muqbil ibn Hadi al-Wadi'i. You know, a man, Imam, big scholar. He was Shi'i, Zaydi. He went to study in Saudi, he came back, he started teaching Tawheed and Sunnah. A lot was coming to him. So there was a guy called Abdul Malik al-Houthi. Zaydiya, they're not like Rafida, you know? So one, they start going to Iran. Iran start weaponizing them, giving them weapons. They start killing the Sunnis in Sa'da. Tayyip, when the people rebelled and get Saleh, the Houthis were weaponized by Iran to take over the country. When they start killing the Muslims there, the Sunnis, now Iran is on a mission to take over many countries. Saudi, even, I forgot about United Nations, but even United Nations accepted that Saudi should get involved to help Yemenis. Do you know why? Because Yemenis asked for the help. So Yemen and Saudi now have a right to help someone that's been oppressed. Is that true or not? If someone's been oppressed. I'm not saying, because a brother came to me 2 weeks ago, said if he's allowed to kill Houthis. I said, you're not allowed to go kill anyone. Except if someone's going to come to kill you. Houthi, a Yahudi, not allowed to kill people. Except if someone comes to attack you, defend yourself. Even if you're a Muslim brother, try to kill you, fight back. You understand? So we're not talking. But Saudi not doing the same Iran. Iran is helping to destroy Muslim countries. Saudi not doing that, alhamdulillah. Do you understand? That's what my point. My point, you didn't know the history behind why Saudi got involved. Because Saudi is going to push a lot of Shia, Bahrain. Saudi got involved in Bahrain. Alhamdulillah, Allah saved Bahrain. Because there's a lot of Shia and who's behind is Iran. That's why Iran hates Saudi. Because the only country that is exposing the plan of Iran and Ikhwa al-Muslimin is Saudi. A lot of people don't know it.
How do you collect this information?
Huh?
How do you collect all this information?
I'll tell you how. You, the Shia, whose name al-Qurani, Qurani, he was praising.
I used to be a Shia. Somewhere.
He's gonna have heart attack, brother.
I'm a Sunni.
Hello, let me speak.
I'm a Sunni.
Abu Abdullah, you're talking about the time. Anyway, speak. Let's speak to him. Speak to him.
You are a Sunni.
I spoke to him many times. You're talking about
the time. Why did you call yourself Sunni?
From France.
And when he.
Yeah, he's talking about the time. Waste of time. Wallah, it's waste of time, Abdullah. Abu Abdullah.
You're scared from me. I'm answering you. Where did you collect? I said.
I just told you. He cut me off.
Al-Qurani.
No, no, wait, let me finish. What are you going to say, what are you going to say? No, no, let
me. You
go finish.
Yeah.
They all get orders from Iran. Yes. And you know what? There is Khomeini himself. He said Iran is
Hezbollah. Listen.
What do you believe?
Everybody believes.
Like, don't let us, let's just shut up. Don't let us digress to many subjects. Let's go back. Abdullah is here. Guys, go back. No, wait. Yeah. Wait. Yeah, 1914, yeah.
Did they fight each other?
Anyway, the point here. See, let me finish. Let me tell you off.
Okay, what do you mean?
No, it's like a cassette. Anyway, the point here is that what the brother said, he was Shi'i, he becomes Sunni, alhamdulillah. He was a Shi'i, he becomes Sunni too. He's from Iran, alhamdulillah.
I was a Sunni, I become Shi'i.
No, you've never been, you only love Shi'i, Abu Abdullah. And if you become Sunni, I'll take go back Shi'i, please. Because we don't want someone like you. No, astaghfirullah. You know, I told, well, you know what I asked Abu Abdullah? Give me a proof to full Ahl Bayt. You know what he told me? Yeah. Surah Al-Fatiha. I don't know how he understood from Surah Al-Fatiha to full Ahl Bayt. Wallah, I don't know. Anyway, Abu Abdullah, you just harassing, yeah? Well, listen, the point here is that the Qurani, and before that Khomeini, he mentioned that we work with Ikhwan al-Muslimin, and we work with Hezbollah, as Baba Hezbollah Shaitan, and we work with Ansar al-Quds. Look at the name, Ansar al-Quds. But the Ansar Shaitan, Ansar al-Quds. You know, because they want to deceive the Muslims. They work with them to cause destruction in Muslim countries. Khomeini mentioned that. It's live, you get it, go watch it. It's ma'roof. However, the Ikhwan, who are controlling the media, they don't let you to hear that. You know, Wallahi, I don't want to hear you that. Abdullah.
Between me and you, he moving himself, he wants me to go away. Shall I go if you want?
Yeah, you go, yes.
Yeah, thank you.
Hadakallah al-Islam.
Okay, you're welcome.
Ameen. Min duni Allahi.
Min duni
Allahi. Yeah, Allahi. Because al-Kasr, ism al-Jalayt. Yeah, min duni Allahi. No, no, we don't laugh at him, because I make mistakes as well. To be honest, even me, I'll make mistakes. Yeah. And it's clear, min duni Allahi, min duni Allahi, min duni Allahi, min duni Allahi. Min duni Allahi, yeah.
What do you mean by min duni Allahi? What
means
min duni Allahi?
Anyway, take cover. My point here is, look, khuya. He didn't know that. He didn't know about the Houthis, how he started, and so on. In Syria, what happened? The Muslims, they were fighting. Who got involved? Iran.
Yeah.
Saada?
Yeah,
they were killed. They were killed by the Houthis.
But they've been asked to leave Saada.
Huh?
Being asked to leave
Saada. The Sunnis there, they had to leave Saada. And you know who? Some of them, yes, they're from other countries, come study, but some of them from Saada. And they had to leave, akhi. They were killed, akhi. Naam, I mentioned that about the hadith in Damash. Naam. That hadith, and is Imam Muqbil ibn Hadi al-Wadi'i. You know, subhanAllah. Iran, they said they have, what they call it, they have a nuclear weapon. Why don't you free Palestine?
Why? Because Iran...
Simple question. Yeah. Then the borders. What are you doing? You got killed the Muslims, Sunnis in Iran, in Syria. Why don't you free Palestine? To show you're liars. You know what they say? As a Saudi, they're scared. No problem. For the sake of argument. You are the brave. You have a nuclear weapon. Why don't you free Palestine? It's just a lies. You know, they just talk. Because why? You know people... Yeah, you have the way. Go. How come you went to Syria?
Against Iran, you stand. Who are you, Saudi Arabia? You are doing. Do you think you are doing the right? You are.
Alhamdulillah, Saudi
have defending Israel. Look at
defending Israel. Look at them. You know. Excellent.
Thank you, Shamsi. Thank you.
Huh?
Thank you.
You are Kumaki. Saudi are Tawhid and Sunnah. Iran is Shirk and Kufr.
How do I get to Israel and you are in the middle?
No, how do you get to Syria then?
I was in Syria and you...
No, how come Iran? Abu Abdullah, Iran is in Syria. It's in Syria, is it?
Syria is in...
So you used to go to Israel?
Yeah.
So where did you go? You don't want to go? Yeah, what about Lebanon? Lebanon, the Hezbollah, they're killing the Sunnis in Iran. Hezbollah. Yeah. Wallah, Hezbollah. Shia? No, by the way, when I say Shia, I'm not talking...
Baba.
I didn't have the Raji for this. You need half the Raji. You know that there's Algerian commentator. You need that one for that. Yeah. That's what you need, wallahi. That's Algerian commentator for football.
Can you? Never.
Yeah. Watch. Abu Abdullah, you become like an Indian Christian guy. You keep harassing us. Take care of yourself. May Allah guide you. Okay. Okay, watch this. Give me one verse for Ahl Bayt. One verse.
One verse, so many. But I'm going to give you...
One verse. For clear.
Don't
clear.
Tell me this is half ayah.
No, one clear verse. Everyone can understand this. Read it. Read it to us.
You forgot.
Take care. Bye bye. Take finish. ويطهركم ويطهركم
ويطهركم
ويطهركم.
Same what you said.
It's not. But this is not verse.
Not verse. Have a verse, huh?
That's it. It's half verse.
Have a verse.
وقمنا في بيوتكن ولا تبرج تبرج جهل الأولى. Let me finish.
Is it going? Who's قرن?
وقرنا في بيوتكن.
Allah said. Where did this goes down? Where?
This is here. Show the verse.
Listen.
Oh, it's a كلام أبو عبد الله تكه خلاص. لا. لا يجوز كلام معك. لا يجوز كلام معك. لا يجوز. لا. إمام الشافعي قال ناظرت 100 عالم غلبته ناظرني جاهل غلبني. He's gonna defeat me. He's gonna defeat me.
He, أخي, I said to him, he's gonna finish.
Let me translate for you what he said. Yeah, I told him, can you give me a clear verse where Allah stated in the Quran to full Ahl Bayt? He said, Allah said, Inna ma yuridu Allah. Verily, Allah wants to purify you or Ahl Bayt. Yeah. From this, wait. Let me finish. This verse is not even a verse. It's half of it. The full verse, Allah speaking about the wives. وقرن في بيوتكن. Stay at your homes. ولا تبرج وقرن في بيوتكن ولا تبرج بالجهة الأولى. وآتينا الزكاة وأطعنا الله وأقمنا الصلاة وآتينا الزكاة وأطعنا الله ورسوله. إنما يريد الله ليذهب عنكم رجز البيت ويطهركم تطهيرا. This verse speaking about the wives, yeah. And from this verse you will never understand Ahl Bayt means the 12 Imams of the Shia. Rather from this verse, as Allah mentioned in Surah Ibrahim, the verse number 73, when the Malaika approached the wife of Ibrahim, they said to her, أَتَعْجَبِينَ مِنْ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ رَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ عَلَيْكُمْ. They addressed Ahl Bayt, it's Ahl Bayt. They addressed the wife of Ibrahim this with Mim al-Jama'a.
The mother of the Prophet you're talking about.
Wait. No, he's making up, he's making up. The wife. The point here is Allah referred to the wife of Ibrahim as Ahl Bayt. So Ahl Bayt are the wives. Now from the Quran, he will never bring it. From the Quran. Look, he's not gonna let me finish.
He answered you already.
Allah. Yes. He said the waqt, of time. Abu Abdullah.
What's mean Ahl Bayt?
This Azwaj. الأولاد أهل البيت.
No.
الله said أزواج أهل البيت. The wives.
Okay.
In the Quran Allah said وقمنا في بيوتكن ولا تبرج تبرج جاهل الأولى وقمنا الصلاة. أخي من القرآن احترم القرآن يا أخي.
شيعة
يحترم القرآن. ليس كل شيعة بهم.
إن
لوك نو قرآن. شيعة دي ونفع القرآن. شيعة دي قرآن للقرآن.
No.
Wait.
Say
عليه الصلاة والسلام.
صلى الله عليه وآله
وسلم. If you say Ali, watch Ali.
Huh?
Ali.
Ali was under the kisa.
Under kisa as well.
Never on his wife.
Wait.
Muhammad under.
So let us deal with this. Yeah?
Yeah.
From the Quran, clearly the wives are Ahl Bayt. So now Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam wants to include Ali, wal Hassan, wal Hussein. How he's going to do it from the Quran is not there. From the Quran is the wives. Yeah. So Ahl Sunnah we say from the Quran the wives are Ahl Bayt, but from the Hadith. Hassan wal Hussein wa Ali Fatima are Ahl Bayt. So there's no contradiction because wait. Because
He said
you have no answer, but he's not allowed me to answer.
You making Allah doesn't know Fatima is a daughter of Muhammad.
Listen,
that's your answer.
In the Quran, Allah said the wives are Ahl Bayt. It's Fatima, his wife.
Where is he?
وقرنا.
قرن.
أنت حما ولا يا شهادة.
قرن.
والله وقرنا نون النسوة يا أخي.
Okay, give me.
No, take care of yourself. Take care of yourself. والله. وقرنا. أنت نون هذه نون النسوة ومنون الرجال.
نون النسوة.
علي
إنما يريد الله ليذهب عنكم الرس على البيت.
أخي والله يا أخي. لا أخي ما يفهم.
قرنا الاقتران أهل البيت.
ما يفهم هذا في البيت.
Not منزل. See that's why I'm asking him. Not منزل أهل البيت. أهل البيت أهل الأمر.
وقرنا في بيوتكن.
بيوتكن.
بيوتكن. إنجلش هذه. بيوتكن.
بيوت. See many بيوت many.
Because he had nine wives, Prophet Sallam.
And look, continue
that. Ah, Adam, bad, bad, bad. Bye. Allah, Akhi.
Ahl
al-Bayt, bayt, one. Bayt, one, not beyut, akunna. Huh? I'll show you. Allah, Akhi, this is the time, Akhi. This is what I'm saying. I'm not going to say.
Ahl al-Bayt and beyut.
Where's different? Where's different? Where's different? Where's different?
Huh? Different بيت واحد. إنما يريد الله ليذهب عن كبرس أهل البيت. There is وقرنا في بيوتكن. So many
بيوتكن.
Yes.
ما بيوتكن. بيوتكن.
It doesn't matter. Don't. You have to understand.
It does. وخلنا في في إز حرف جر. بيوتكن.
Okay. I learn from you. Okay. You teach me. Good.
No.
بيوتكن. Or بيوتكن.
How can you speak out the Quran?
Okay. What do you say? بيوتكن. Okay. بيوتكن. Many بيوت. So many houses.
Okay.
But here is talk about one house.
Where? For beauty kunna.
Innama yurid Allah liyudhib. Allahumma ha'ula'i ahli bayti fadhub anhum ar-rizq before the ayah. Allah give them. Innama yurid Allah liyudhib ankum ar-rizq ahli al-bayt wa yutahharam kutatira. Lakin, روح قل للنسوانك ان يقرن في بيوتهن ولا يتبرجن
بيوتنهن
ايه
وعربي لا فرنسي لا انجليزي ولا انجلش سبيك. Wait, you finish, yeah? Now, to show you that these people don't read Arabic, Quran. That's the mushkil. It's Arabic, but it doesn't understand Quran. And now in the Quran, in the Quran, if you go to the verse, firstly, remember he goes to Hadith to show you Shia, Quran is not with them. But we say Quran Hadith to us. Okun the Shia, if the Hadith go and guess the Quran, what should you do?
Wallahi,
I'm asking you a question. I'm asking you. He's not going to answer. Abu Abdullah. When Hadith go and guess the Quran, what should you do? Okun the Shia's belief. Okay. From the Quran, show me one verse in the Quran says cousins are Ahl al-Bayt. One verse from the Quran.
Cousins Ahl al-Bayt?
Yeah, from the Quran, show me.
Never.
In the Quran, does it say the wives are Ahl al-Bayt?
In the Quran, what?
Does it say the wives are Ahl al-Bayt from the Quran?
Never.
Okay,
only Ibrahim. Only Ibrahim.
That's his wife.
His wife and his cousin and the
No. She had no.
Look,
he's not
going
to finish. Abu Abdullah, listen. What are we talking about? No, firstly, what is he talking about?
I'm giving you.
Abu Abdullah, step by step. The verse in the Quran is Surah Al-Hud. Let me finish.
Understanding. If you understand what's being made,
then they say why you walk away.
It's not a house.
Then they say why you walk away. Habibi, please. Stop it. Don't digress. Yeah. Don't digress. Okay, the point here is, the verse is clear. In Surah Hud, Allah يقول لي الملائكة تقول لي زوج إبراهيم.
Who is زوج إبراهيم?
Sarah.
Who is Sarah?
زوج إبراهيم.
زوج
إبراهيم. This number. Take care, Nana. Anyway, take care of yourself. أخي, he's
the wife of Muhammad.
Okay. Watch. The wife of Ibrahim. Okay. Allah in the Quran clearly addressing the wife as Ahl Bayt.
Yeah.
In Surah Al-Qasas,
yeah.
Allah said, وَسَارَ بِأَهْلِهِ.
Yes.
Okun Shia sources and the Sunnah sources. أَهْلِهِ mean Musa and his wife.
Yes.
Allah called us his Ahl. Yes? So what is known in the Quran? The wives are Ahl Bayt. From the hadith now, if you say no, is the hadith go against the Quran, you should not use it. But Ahl Sunnah is saying there's no contradiction. Like I said, from the Quran, the wives are Ahl Bayt. From the hadith, we take Fatima, wal Hassan, wal Hussein, wa Ali Ahl Bayt. That's how we combine. Because that verse you quote is not even. Let me finish, Abu Abdullah. That verse you quote to show you don't even know the Quran. That verse, what is before it and what is after it, Allah clearly addressing the wives of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. Rather, Surah Ahzab, majority of the verses, Allah addressing Azwaj, Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. Clearly, it's about the wives. So what you did, you took half of verse out of context. So what I would say to you, again, according to Shia's belief, the Ahl Bayt, can you show me from the Quran,
Al-Bayt.
No.
Will
the Quran.
No, the Quran.
No.
See?
Do you accept Sunnah?
Do you accept Sunnah?
I accept Sunnah.
Okay. Prophet
Muhammad.
No. Okay.
Prophet Muhammad said.
Why did you accept
Isa? I just explained it. I accept it.
I'm not taking Sunnah from you. I'm taking Sunnah from Muhammad sallallahu alaihi
wasallam. Sallam.
Why did he put Al-Kisa on him, not the wife?
That's a good question. I've already answered it. He was not listening. I said to you, from the verse in the Quran, if you read Surah Al-Ahzab, Allah speaking clearly, explicitly about the azwaj of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. So from the verse, from the Quran, can someone get the verses, let him read it. I want to read it, yeah? Read the verses. Clearly it's about azwaj. يا أيها النبي, even that verse يا أيها النبي قل لأزواجك. So when you read, it's أزواج أزواج أزواج, the wives, the wives, the wives. So from the Quran, أهل السنة, we take the wives are أهل البيت. From the Hadith, we take that الحسن والحسين وعلي وفاطمة أهل البيت. That verse when Allah said, إنما يريد الله ليذهب عنكم الرجز أهل البيت ويطهركم تطهيرا. It's not just about the wives, also about the other members of Ahl Bayt. How can we know that? From the Hadith. Okay. That's how we combine between the two okay. sources. Okay. Do you understand?
I understand.
What do you say?
So, I'm going to answer you with my
answer. I never ask you a question. How are you going to answer me?
Listen.
What do you say?
Okay, if you say like this, yeah. Why didn't Muhammad lock the door and windows and without the material and said, Allahumma ha'ula Ahl Bayt?
I don't know about locking doors. I don't know about locking doors and windows. What I know in the Hadith is Sahih Muslim. Yeah. The Hadith is Sahih Muslim. He got the kisa, the rida, yeah. And he said, Ahl Bayt.
Yeah. Yeah. So what I would say, the kisa over the Kaaba, what's the kisa? Answer me. Why didn't Kisa Ahl Bayt?
You have to let me finish.
No.
Kaaba is Ahl Bayt as well.
No, that's Baytullah. And the masajid, Baytullah.
What are you talking about?
Why don't you have kisa on the masajid?
Kisa, what are you talking about?
See, you don't understand.
Well, please, can someone explain to me?
Wallah,
I don't understand him. I don't understand Abu Abdullah. From the wives and the daughters, talking about kisa, masjid, house. Curtain, window.
Let me
talk about windows and doors.
Ahl al-Bayt is me.
Abu Abdullah, Allah yahdik. Abu Abdullah, Abu Abdullah, Abu Abdullah, Abu Abdullah. Firstly, you have asked my question. My question, can you show me your belief from the Quran?
Ahl al-Bayt, Ahl al-Amr. Ahl al-Sha'n. The matter people, the matter people. The issue.
Can anyone translate what he's saying?
Yeah.
Can anyone explain to me, please? Even if you are Shi'i, come and explain to me.
أهل الأمر, أهل الشأن, أهل البيت.
إخوان, look this verse, yeah.
قاعدين بالمجالس بالهاي يقولون نحن أهل البيت. Without why.
والله, look this verse, yeah. Let him read it. You read it.
I can't read.
You cannot read.
No.
No problem. It's okay. No, don't mock him. If he cannot read, he cannot. This guy is rich man. He knows how to read. I'm telling you, but he's pretending.
No, I don't want
to. You know how to read.
I believe you read. Read it for me.
No, but just to show you that this verse, when you read, yeah, is about look. Even it goes on after, yeah?
Yeah.
وَذْكُلْنَا مَا يُتْلَى فِي بُيُوتْ No, عَلَيْكُنَّا إِنَّا أَبُو عَبْدِ اللَّهِ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ فِي بُيُوتِكُنَّا مِنْ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ وَالْحِكْمَةِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ لَطِيفًا خَبِيرًا إِنَّ الْمُسْلِمِينَ والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والقانتين والقانتات والصادقين والصادقات والصابرين والصابرات والخاشعين والخاشعات والمتصدقين والمتصدقات والصائمين والصائمات والحافظين فروجهم والحافظات والذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات أعد الله لهم مغفرة وأجرا عظيما. So when you read the Quran,
where is the rich?
No, read whole Quran here.
Where is Tafheer? Where is the rich?
He doesn't know, we already passed it.
I'm talking about
it's a calamity.
This is out of the
هداك الله أبو عبد الله. أبو عبد الله الله يهديك. الله يهديك والله.
I know, I like you والله.
أبو عبد الله. You know, أبو عبد الله even had to screw with him, but inshallah, I think he's coming to Ahl Sunnah soon. You know, أبو عبد الله, I think he's مفعول القلم. Maybe the parents believe that for him. Like literally, we were speaking about the wives. We were speaking about the Kaaba, houses, windows.
That's because
are you carpenter?
Because you don't understand what's been a kisa or
Kaaba. What are you talking about? Wallah,
Kaaba over the kisa, and you don't know. What's Muhammad put a kisa on him? You don't.
No problem.
Know.
No problem.
And what did they?
Watch this. Watch this. Okay.
Did the wife of
the 12 imams.
No. Answer my question. Did the if they understand the ayah like this?
Yeah.
The wife قرنها في بيوتها.
That's a question. Ask the question. Did they قرن في بيوت? Mean did they stay at home?
Yes.
They stayed at home, but of necessity they were allowed to leave the house.
Who told them to?
Wait. Because the Nabi عليه الصلاة والسلام, when this verse was revealed, he allowed his wife Aisha to go out with her brother Abu Bakr. No, Abu Bakr. His Asar, a brother, I forgot his name. Therefore, Abu Bakr never understood who he understand the Quran better than you and I, that they have to stay at home 24/7. Out of necessity they were allowed to leave. رضي الله عنهن وأرضاهن. And the wives of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when we speak about them, we speak about respect. Because Allah already mentioned that the wives of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, they are our mothers. So we love them, we Allah bless them, may Allah reward them, may Allah be pleased with them. So whatever you're going to say about them after they come out, because Aisha came out, tried to rectify the problems, may Allah be pleased with her. That was her ijtihad, And that's it. We keep quiet about our the mothers. Okay. My mothers, we keep our quiet about them. Khalas, ayya. May Allah guide you to Islam. Take care of yourself. سبحانك الله بحمدك. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت. أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. Yeah, yeah, that's what I'm saying. No problem. Out of necessity, عبد الله عبد الله. No, she went for rectification. No, كلاب النار.
كلاب الحوام.
لا ساعة كلاب النار. But it doesn't mean, yes, yes. No, عفوا يصير كلاب النار, عفوا. عفوا يصير كلاب النار.
No
problem. The point here is, Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, Allah in the Quran clearly mentioned that the wives of the Nabi sallam, they are our mothers.
Of course.
So how do you speak with, how you speak about your mother with respect? Especially not any mother, no. The wife of the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So I'm not going to allow you to say anything about Aisha. Yes, خلاص, stop here. No. The Quran, what did he say about Aisha?
أن تتوب إلى الله فقد سقط
كل نعم أنت ما توبة
وأن طلقهن سوف يزوجهن
دي طلقهن نو therefore they are أحسن women
عسى
نعم
عسى
نعم
ربه أن طلقهن
عسى أنت في عسى you know in Arabic language عسى أبو عبد الله عسى in Arabic language sometimes it comes as تأكيد exactly. No, so now the verse that you just recited yeah. shows that Aisha and Hafsa they are the best women because Allah جل وعلا will never leave his prophet with a woman that is lesser because Allah has mentioned the Quran. Let me finish the verse. The verse Allah mentioned that if you don't make tawbah, then Allah will exchange you with wives, the women that are better than you. And we know historically from the Shia sources and the Sunnah sources that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam never exchanged his wives. So therefore, they are the best women. May Allah please of them. The case is closed. That's it. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته بارك الله فيكم